Well, it's a regular little burning this morning. There's fires going everywhere. It turned pretty chilly again last night. We don't know why. But that's life. There's Fam. Look, he's cooking his sticky rice. Say good morning. Hello, mate. So he's got that going. Good, huh? Good. Pye's got an inferno over there going. And there's a few others down there. Oh, there's another fire there. Another fire up there. Oh, nice and warm though. Not overly cold, but it's yeah, got a bit of a chill in the air last night. Not sure why. It's about 6:20 now, so Fam's getting himself ready for school. His little sticky rice and some food. And then he'll be off. And time for us to go to the farm. We'll catch you in a bit. Well, Dad went off this morning to go and do some shrimp catching. And he caught a load. And he sold them for 80 baht. So he's happy. I'll wait, mate, a few bucks, eh? Pye, she's there chopping up pumpkin for the ducks. You having a good time there, baby? What a palaver, innit? Oh, dear. And Pye found my sunglasses, my 99 baht sunglasses. So I'm not allowed to wear my Ray-Bans. There you go. That's my 99 baht sunglasses. But it keeps the sun out of my eyes. All the old monks are out getting alms. And as you can see, we've got our eggs out on the roadside for sale. And these are the dried fish that Pye made. And then she sells these with this like cabbage sauce. I don't know what it is, it's sour. Not very busy this morning on the road. Pretty quiet. Dad busy though. Looks like it's going to be a beautiful day though. No cloud out there at all, so it'll be a scorcher. Going back to the catching shrimp, this is how it's done. So you've got like these little pods, and the shrimp go in there, and there's a column in here. If I pull it out, and what they do is they take this column and they fill it up with food. Generally fish food, just a little bit of fish food at the bottom, and then put it back in there. And then just sink it in the water. As you can see, he's got loads of them. And that's how they catch their shrimp. Cool, isn't it? Again, I find this so interesting, this type of life. It's just, you know, there's always something going on because it's not just a case of farming a bit of rice. It's corn, it's tobacco, there's the fish, the ducks, the chickens. It's you know, then of course ant eggs, as you've seen, and shrimp. Always something going on. It's always an interesting day. There's never a dull day here, that's a fact. Well, somebody asked me yesterday if I could show you the when we feed the fish. And here we go. You can see now as we walk down the bank, they're all starting to come up. And as you throw food in, they're like piranha. I think they could strip a man in about 30 seconds flat. So yeah, let's put some food in there. There you go. Hungry little devils, aren't they? Well, I did say that once you start feeding them, that's it. They are getting bigger though. And Pye literally just walk all the way along here now, just putting food in. And they come a running. Like I said, we originally put in about 11,500 fish. So there's a lot of fish in there. Very cool, isn't it? I love it. I I've got to go and check on that chicken this morning, see if I can find it and see if it's still alive. I did have a quick look around, but couldn't see it. But I'll keep on looking, make sure it's all right. Beautiful walking up and down here first thing in the morning, though. And again, I've not quite figured it out why I get so much pleasure out of feeding the fish, but I do. I can't wait till they sort of at least about half a kilo, and then I'll get a rod in here. That'll be nice. Spoke to my father-in-law about the fish, and he said at the rate they're growing now, they should be ready for harvesting in between 2 to 3 months. So there you go, that's us feeding our fish. Twice a day, we're kind of ramping it up to 3 times a day, so I'll come back late afternoon and just give them some more food, and then around about dusk, I'll just come back and just give them another sprinkling. So they're always hungry, that's a fact, they can eat. Right, I'm going chicken hunting, see if I can find that chicken. Okay there? Yeah? As you can see, there's quite a bit of mist on the mountains this morning. Just a glorious sight though. Rice is doing well. That's now turning green, a treat. Doesn't take long, really doesn't take that long. I'm glad I've found my shades though. Keeps the bright light out of my eyes, that's a fact. Again, you know, it's such an interesting way to live. You just see everything sort of growing and, you know, new life all the time. It's it really is an interesting way to live. Certainly a challenge. I mean, there's no two ways about that. Having to battle against the elements and Mother Nature. But yeah, it makes life very, very interesting. Now this over here, I've got like a hut. All this land, all the way in there, is my mother-in-law's sister's farm. Just a glorious place though. The mornings here are my favourite because, you know, you get all the mist on the mountains and, you know, everything's so fresh. The air, I said, you know, it's just so clean up here. Hey, yeah, it is, yeah, truly fabulous, really, really fabulous. Well, I've just found that chicken. Still got a little bit of blood around its head, but as you can see, it's eating away and it's quite healthy. So it's recovered quite nicely. Cool. Well, I'm here at the back of the farm, actually on our neighbour's farm. And you can see they got a little pond here going. It's really nice. And I don't know whether you can see it, but just in there, right there, it's got water coming out. Obviously it's being fed from the rice field, so quite a smart little idea. So he floods his rice field and then it just trickles in here and keeps the pond topped up. Again, you know, the pond is really great, but now that we're moving into the dry season, it's going to be a challenge to keep that pond topped up. It's going to cost quite a few bucks because we've got to run the dak, but you can see here that the rice fields are all flooded and it's just feeding into the pond. Nice though, he's got a nice little pond there. It is lovely out here though, isn't it? It is such a stunning location. It's a sort of place you just can't get tired of looking at. You know, if you love your nature and you love the countryside, then I can't think of a better place. I really couldn't. Still a lot of mist on the back of the mountains there though. And you can see the creek now, it's almost dry. But I suspect now within the next 2 weeks this will be absolutely bone dry. It'll be as dry as this. Again, constantly a challenge, but an enjoyable one. Just love being here though. There's so much to explore. Well, cleaned up a load of this round here and just burning off all the old leaves and twigs. Got a couple of piles going on there. As you can see, pollen's just piling on the old leaves. Still looking for snakes. I haven't seen the snakes on the pond for a while. I've seen them on a few occasions slithering across, but nothing recently, absolutely nothing. I'll keep looking, I will. I'll get them on camera yet. Well, it's now 9:35 and all the animals are fed, and Pi and I have been cracking on with cleaning up the pond area. It is a battle all the time because of all the leaves off the trees. But yeah, looks nice, isn't it? Just burn a load of the old leaves off. Dad's out in the field, sorting out the rice. Always busy. Always something to do. And we've got a new cockerel. Now, for some mysterious reason, our prize cockerel died. Why he died and what he died of, we don't know. But Dad went and bought a new one. He actually bought three. And they're called a mountain chicken because they live up in the mountains. And apparently they're highly priced. But 400 baht for three chickens. And I don't know where he's gone now. He was around here. Ah, he's up there. Yeah, crowing away, look. He's, yeah, lovely, isn't he? How about that for a nice boy? He's a bad boy, isn't he? Yeah. And he's already performing, if you know what I mean. So, little ducklings are doing great. Yep. More chickens on the way. Right, I'm going to get back on and give Pi a hand, and we're going to head on to the house and go and get a bite to eat. Well, we ended up finishing at the farm a lot later this morning than we thought. We didn't get away until about 11 o'clock. But it's looking much, much better. It's, yeah, it's cleaner, tidier. Now, what we've got to do is put some water in this pond, so it needs topping up. Dad's just cooked himself lunch. Got a fish soup going. It looks quite nice, but of course loads of chilli. Here it is. You see all the chilli in that though. Ooh. That's what you call spicy. Really spicy. So what we're going to do, we're going to fire up the dak dak when Dad's had his lunch and put in the pipe in and get this pond filled up. Lovely. But yeah, it's all good. Happy, happy, beautiful day. I said this morning it was going to be a scorcher, and it's lovely out here. It took us nearly 2 hours to dismantle the pipeline from the new pond and reassemble it to the old pond. It took a while to get the pump working again. There was air in there, so we had to take it apart again. Trials and tribulations. Whew. And it's hot out here. Wow. So as you can see, it's running through the pipeline. They're just going to connect it all up now and then run it out into the old pond. Never stops. But it, again, you know, it does make for an interesting life because you don't get time to get bored. It's full on all the time. I mean, what you actually see on a daily basis is just a fraction of what goes on. But, especially with my father-in-law and Pi. Oh, they know how to work. Oh, never known anybody to work like she does, though. So as you can see, we've got the pipeline pointing into the old pond, and within the next few minutes we should get water coming in. Well, there you go, guys. There is water being pumped into the old pond. And hopefully by the morning, we'll leave the dak dak running overnight. This will be full up again. We were going to go down to the municipal lake and get a load more of those plants. The ones that we put in the old pond, the ducks ate them. So, yeah, we're going to have to try and figure out something where the ducks have got a bit of space but they don't go near the plants, because we're hoping those plants are going to clean up that water. So, yeah, it's all right though, isn't it? So tomorrow, that's our job for tomorrow. We're going to take the truck and go down to the pond and get those plants. Well, guys, lots and lots still here to do, so I've got to close off. And see you tomorrow. Me and Pi will carry on here for another few hours, and I'm going to get back and do some editing. and then get this video posted online for you. Remember guys, have a fantastic day and stay safe, and thank you very much for watching. Don't forget, please subscribe, share and like. It does make a huge difference. And we'll see you tomorrow. Bye for now, guys.